Hello friends, today I will explain refrigeration, terms related to refrigeration, types of refrigeration and comparison with refrigeration. So first, refrigeration. Refrigeration means producing and maintaining the temperature below atmospheric temperature is known as refrigeration. Then refrigerating effect. Cooling effect produced by refrigerating system is known as refrigerating effect. Coefficient of performance means it is a ratio of refrigerating effect and work supply. Different types of refrigeration systems are there. First, vapor compression refrigeration system, and second, vapor absorption refrigeration system. In this, first we'll see that vapor compression refrigeration system. In vapor compression refrigeration system, we'll see vapor compression refrigeration system, its components, working. Then representation of vapor compression refrigeration system on pH and TH diagram, and subcooling and superheating of the vapor compression refrigeration system. So first we'll see vapor compression refrigeration system. See here, this is a diagram of line diagram of vapor compression refrigeration system. Main components of the vapor compression refrigeration systems are compressor, condenser, expansion device and evaporator. Function of compressor is to compress the refrigerant, vapor refrigerant. Function of condenser is to condense the refrigerant. Function of expansion device is to expand the refrigerant. And function of evaporator is to produce the cooling effect. In evaporator, that liquid refrigerant, it is vaporizing into the vapor refrigerant. In compressor, now at point 1, that here in this vapor compression refrigeration system, different types of refrigerants are used, and that forms of the refrigerant where it is entering and leaving in each components are like this. At point 1, low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerants are entering into inside the compressor. In compressor, pressure is increased, and that high pressure, high temperature vapor refrigerants are delivered to the condenser. In condenser, there are two types of condenser, air-cooled condenser or water-cooled condenser. Here, that heat which is absorbed in the evaporator and heat which is added in the compressor, it is rejected to the atmosphere through condenser. In condenser, there is a phase change. Liquid vapor refrigerant is converted to liquid refrigerant, and where it is leaving from the condenser, it is high pressure, high normal temperature liquid refrigerant. Receiver, that is a device which is used for that storage of the refrigerant before supplying to the expansion device. In expansion device, again, whatever pressure which is raised in the compressor, that pressure we have to decrease in the expansion device. In expansion device, that is a capillary tube. In expansion device, that high pressure, normal temperature liquid refrigerant is entering, and when it is leaving from the expansion device, there is a decrease in pressure. Accordingly, there is a decrease in temperature. Temperature goes below 0 degree centigrade, and when it is leaving from the expansion device, it is a low pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant. And when that low pressure, low temperature liquid refrigerant, it is supplied to the evaporator. Evaporator, it is kept in the system which is to be cooled, and when it is moving inside the evaporator, at that time that liquid refrigerant, it absorbs heat from the surrounding, and surrounding becomes cooled. That is, cooling effect is produced. That is the output of the refrigeration system. And when that heat is absorbed, that again there is a phase change, and liquid refrigerant is converted to vapor refrigerant, and those vapor refrigerants are again entering, sucked by the compressor. And compressor is doing two functions. It is increasing the pressure as well as it is circulating the refrigerant in the closed cycle. Output we are getting in the evaporator, and input we have to supply to the compressor. Output is refrigerating effect. Input is work supplied. Output upon input, that is RE upon W, that is known as coefficient of performance of the refrigeration system. Now here, different types of processes which is happening in different components are 1 to 2, that is adiabatic compression process. 2 to 3, this process, it is happening in the condenser. It is a constant pressure condensation process. 3 to 4, that is a throttling process. Here, expansion process, it is throttling process. And 4 to 1, it is a constant pressure evaporation process. These processes are represented on pH and TL diagram. It is like this. So this is a
representation of vapor compression cycle on pH and TH diagram. So this is pH diagram and this is TH diagram. On pH diagram, see 1 to 2, this is a compression process. It is adiabatic compression. Here that enthalpy increases, pressure also increases at the time of compression. So that is curved line 1 to 2. 2 to 3, it is a constant pressure condensation process. It is shown like this. Then 3 to 4, it is a throttling process. Here enthalpy, it is same before throttling and after throttling. That's why it is a straight line. But at the time of throttling process, there is a decrease in pressure and accordingly there is a decrease in temperature. So it is a straight line. 4 to 1, this is evaporation process. And here, heat is absorbed from the substance which is to be cooled or system which is to be cooled. So this is a representation of vapor compression cycle on pH diagram. Same diagram it is shown on the TH diagram. 1 to 2, as it is adiabatic compression process, entropy remains constant and there is a rise in temperature, so it is a straight line. 2 to 2 dash, this is a removal of the sensible heat. Then 2 dash to 3, this is a removal of the latent heat. 3 to 4, this is a throttling process. 4 to 1, this is the evaporation process. So this is a constant pressure evaporation process. This is a representation of vapor compression cycle on TS diagram. Now in vapor compression cycle, here there are two terms are there, superheating and subcooling. So because of the superheating and subcooling, coefficient of performance of the vapor compression cycle increases. And here that subcooling, representation of subcooling and superheating, it is shown on the that pH and TA diagram again. So here superheating means what? Superheating means increasing the temperature of the refrigerant above saturation temperature is known as superheating. And subcooling means decreasing the temperature of the refrigerant below saturation temperature is known as subcooling. And that superheating, it is shown here. So generally in vapor compression cycle, we are preparing dry compression. But if you are getting superheated here, at the end of evaporation, if you are getting superheated refrigerant, then it is there is an increase in the refrigerating effect by 1 to 1 dash. Now see, this is at the end of evaporation. So this is a superheating of the refrigerant after evaporation, and in superheated form, it is entering inside the compressor, and because of that, this is an increase in RE. Previous RE is 4 to 1, and now there is an increase in refrigerating effect 1 to 1 dash. Additional refrigerating effect you are getting, and in the same cycle you are getting more refrigerating effect and coefficient of performance of the refrigeration system increases. So here superheating is shown like this, 1 to 1 dash, then 1 dash to 2 dash, that is a compression, regular compression. 2 to 2 dash, that is the removal of the sensible heat. 2 dash to 3, that is the removal of the latent heat. And 3 to 3 dash, this is subcooling. Subcooling means decreasing the temperature below saturation temperature. Here whatever may be the desired temperature, saturation temperature, that temperature of the refrigerant, it is decreases below saturation temperature because of the more coil is there, length of coil is more, and that subcooling happens 3 to 3 dash, and then from 3 dash to 4, this is a throttling process, and 4 to 1. So 4 to 1, so 4 to 1 dash, this is the evaporation process. Now see, this is subcooling, and here we can see because of the this subcooling and superheating on TS diagram, 1 to 1 dash, this is a superheating. So here on the temperature line, we can see what is the degree of superheat. And here again, this is 1 dash to 2, that is a adiabatic compression. 2 to 2 dash, removal of the sensible heat. 2 dash to 3, removal of the latent heat. 3 to 3 dash, removal of the again sensible heat, that is a subcooling. That also we can see here what by what degree there is a subcooling, and 3 dash to 4, this is. And we can say here that is because of the superheating, this is a rise in refrigerating effect. Because of the subcooling, this is a rise in the refrigerating effect, and input remains constant, and input remains constant and output increases. And so we can say because of the superheating and subcooling, there is a increase in repeating effect, there is an increase in coefficient of performance. So superheating and subcooling, it is generally preferable. Now second type of refrigeration, that is known as vapor absorption refrigeration system. Now difference between vapor compression and vapor absorption refrigeration system is that in vapor compression system we are using compressor, and in vapor absorption system that compressor is replaced by this absorber, then generator, then this pump and this reducing pump. So these components are used instead of compressor. Now working of the vapor, now vapor absorption system is what? In vapor compression system, vapors are compressed by the compressor. And in vapor absorption system, vapors are absorbed by the absorber. In both cases, they are producing the cooling effect. But that output is same, but there is a difference in working and there is a difference in refrigerant use. In vapor absorption system, we are using ammonia as a refrigerant. Now see, this is a diagram of vapor absorption system. I will first tell different components. Most of the components are same, just like vapor compression system. Now see, I will start from the absorber or evaporator. See, this is evaporator, this is absorber. Then from absorber, this is a pump. Here, this is pump. This is a heat exchanger. This is generator. Then this is pressure reducing valve. This is analyzer, rectifier, condenser, receiver, expansion device. Now see, now I wish here evaporator. Now evaporator, it is kept in the system which is to be cooled. It is absorbing heat from the substance which is to be cooled or from the system which is to be cooled. And here again, as told by me previously, in evaporator there is a phase change and low pressure, low temperature vapor, liquid refrigerant is converted into low pressure, low temperature vapor refrigerant, and those are the ammonia vapors. Now here in vapor absorption system, there is a one principle it is used, or one tendency of the water and ammonia it is used. Ammonia is having that is affinity with the water, and when water vapor occurs, that ammonia, it will absorb those water vapors. Now in absorber, there is a water vapor ammonia solution is there, and this ammonia solution, this ammonia solution, it is absorbed by the water which is kept in the absorber. So as soon as ammonia is formed, ammonia vapors are formed in the evaporator, it is absorbed by the absorber, and next ammonia, it will enter inside the evaporator for producing the cooling effect. So that function of the suction, it is done by the absorber. And here, when that ammonia vapors are absorbed, then that water plus ammonia vapor, that is strong solution of the ammonia is formed. And that strong solution of ammonia, it will not absorb more ammonia vapors. So we have to remove that ammonia, strong solution of ammonia, from the absorber. And for that purpose, what is done? We are using pump. And by using pump, we are removing this strong solution of ammonia, that ammonia vapor, strong solution of ammonia, it is moving through this heat exchanger and it is supplied to the generator. In generator, we are heating that strong solution of ammonia below 100 degree centigrade. And here, when that strong solution of ammonia, it is heated, so when saturation temperature of the ammonia, it is reached, that ammonia vapors are separated from the that water ammonia solution and here aqua solution, and that ammonia vapors are moving towards this baffle, and remaining weak solution of ammonia, again it is moving towards absorber. Now here, this weak solution of ammonia, it is hot, and if directly hot solution entering inside the absorber, at that time absorption capacity decreases, and when absorption capacity decreases, rapidic effect inside the evaporator decreases and coefficient of performance decreases. To increase the coefficient of performance, so we are doing that we have to remove the heat from the weak solution of ammonia, and we have to cool that weak solution of ammonia, and that weak solution of ammonia, it is cooled like this. This weak solution of ammonia, it is taken to the heat exchanger. And here in generator, we are supplying that, we are burning the fuel. So input, it is given to the generator. If we decrease the input, then efficiency or coefficient of performance increases. And to decrease the input, so what is to be done? We require strong solution of ammonia in hot form. And here, strong solution of ammonia, it is in cold form. So we request more amount of fuel in the generator. And what is to be done here? That strong solution of ammonia, it is to be heated, and weak solution of ammonia, it is to be cooled. So what is done? It is taken in heat exchanger, and when it comes in contact with each other, that weak solution of ammonia, it gives its heat to the strong solution of ammonia. Weak solution of ammonia get cooled, and strong solution of ammonia get heated. And when it get heated, that amount of fuel which is required in the generator decreases, and thus input decreases. And when the weak solution of ammonia, it is cooled, and Here, when it is again passed to the pressure reducing wall, there is a decrease in pressure, again temperature decreases, and when that weak solution of ammonia enters inside the absorber in cold form, at that time it will absorb more amount of the ammonia vapors, and thus it increases the output. Output increases, input decreases, and overall coefficient of performance increases because of the heat exchanger. So without doing anything, only using heat exchanger, we can improve the coefficient of performance of the vapor absorption system. Now, this ammonia vapors which is formed, if it is containing any water vapors or water particles, so that will be harmful for this cycle. So how it is harmful? If water vapors move towards rectifier, condenser, no problem, it will move through this line. But when it reaches to the expansion device, and when that vapors are here, when liquid refrigerant it is moving through the expansion device, before expansion device its temperature is more than 0 degree centigrade. After expansion device its temperature is less than 0 degree centigrade. And if water particles are appearing in this ammonia vapors, so at that time water particles get freezed here in this pipeline from expansion device to the evaporator, and that pipeline get choked, and next ammonia vapors it will not enter inside the evaporator coil. And what happens? That refriding effects inside the evaporator decreases. So as far as possible, or we have to avoid entry of the water vapor or water particle from the generator to the condenser. And for that purpose we are using analyzer. Analyzer is nothing but it is a baffle type construction. So if water particles are moving here through this baffles, so at that time there is a change in direction, and because of the change in direction, that water particles, say here there is a change in direction because of that speed changes, and water particles are heavier, it is separated from the ammonia vapors, and again it is falling in the generator. And thus this is the analyzer is nothing but it is a mechanical separator of the water particles and ammonia vapors. Only ammonia vapors are entering inside the moving towards condenser. But sometimes if temperature is more and if water particles, water vapors are entering, then this analyzer, it is not capable of removing water vapors, and water vapors are moving towards condenser, and again there is a chances of choking. So what is to be done? If water vapors are entering, we have to remove that water vapor also, and for that purpose we are using one more component. Name of that component is rectifier. Rectifier is nothing but it is also known as partial condenser. So here we are cooling the partially that ammonia vapors plus water vapor, and as saturation temperature of the water vapor it is more than the ammonia vapor, water vapor get condensed earlier than the that water ammonia vapors. Ammonia vapor remains at its it is, water vapor get condensed, it is collected at the bottom of the rectifier, and again it is supplied to the generator, and thus we are removing 100% water particle and water vapor by using this analyzer and rectifier, and only ammonia vapors are now passed towards condenser. In condenser, by using air or water, we are condensing the ammonia vapors. Again, there is a phase change. Ammonia vapors is converted into ammonia liquid, and again, this high pressure, normal temperature, ammonia liquid, it is moved over expansion device. Again, there is a decrease in pressure, decrease in temperature, and low pressure, low temperature, ammonia liquid refrigerant, again it is entering inside the evaporator. It will remove the heat here and it will produce the cooling effect, and this is a working of vapor absorption refrigeration cycle, or this cycle is known as practical vapor absorption refrigeration cycle. Nowadays it is not mostly used because its refrigerating effect is less, space required is more, and as well as its coefficient of performance is less, but it is eco-friendly refrigeration system. Now last point, that is comparison between vapor compression refrigeration system and vapor absorption refrigeration system. Now difference between vapor compression and vapor absorption refrigeration system. In vapor compression refrigeration system, compressor is used. In vapor absorption refrigeration system, compressor is replaced by generator, absorber, then pump and pressure reducing wall. Then second point, that is in vapor compression refrigeration system, as compressor is present, more number of parts are there, more wear and tear takes place in vapor compression refrigeration system. as compared to vapor compression. In vapor absorption reference system, no moving parts are there, so no wear and tear is there. Then next point, as compressor is there, vapor compression reference system is noisy, and as compressor is not there, vapor absorption system is very quiet system. Then in vapor compression system, we are getting the instant cooling effect. In vapor absorption system, we are not getting the instant cooling effect. Then in vapor compression system, it requires high grade energy, that is, we require only electric energy. And in vapor absorption reference system, we can use any type of energy. We can use second grade fuel also. We can use coal, wood, spirit, rock oil, kerosene. Okay, whatever maybe we can use in vapor absorption reference system. Then in vapor compression refrigeration system, there are more chances of the leakages because of the pressure difference. And in vapor absorption reference system, there are less chances of leakages. In vapor absorption system, RE is more, COP is more. In vapor in vapor compression reference system, RE is more and COP is more. And in vapor absorption reference system, RE is less and COP is less. In vapor compression reference system, more maintenance is required. In vapor absorption, less maintenance is required. Charging of the refrigerant is simple in vapor compression refrigeration system. Charging of the refrigerant, it is difficult in vapor absorption refrigeration system. Then there are chances of explosion in vapor compression refrigeration system. There are no chances of explosion as there is a very less pressure difference in vapor absorption refrigeration system. Vapor compression system, it requires less space. Vapor absorption system requires more space, and because of that, nowadays mostly vapor compression refrigeration system is preferred. In vapor compression refrigeration system, we are using that refrigerant like R134A, R143A or halocarbon refrigerant, and in vapor absorption system, we are using ammonia as a refrigerant. So these are the differences between vapor compression and vapor absorption refrigeration system. So this is about refrigeration, then different terms related to refrigeration, and the types of refrigeration, vapor compression, vapor absorption, and comparison between vapor compression and vapor absorption system. Thank you.